Hi, this is Matt. I'm a support engineer at Agilent Technologies, and today we're just going to go over the different connectors that we use with the various different families of N6700 modular power supplies. So we'll go through, show you which connectors go with modules, and we'll talk about the part numbers. So you can order spares, or if you lose one, you can order a new one from Agilent. So let's get started. So this is the first connector we're going to talk about. This is the most common connector. It's for all modules with 12 ampere or less output current. So this is very pervasive in this family. So we're not going to mention the specific models that use it, because we'll mention the models that don't use it when we talk about the other connectors. So the first thing we're going to tell you is that all the modules on the output label on the top has the legend of how to wire your connector. So this little picture here shows you how to connect the wires up on your output connector. So that's useful. So if you ever want to look at how to connect it correctly, always refer to this label. So there's two parts here. This green plug is the output connector, and these little gray and metal pieces are the sense jumpers. So when you want a local sense on the power supply, you basically just take the jumper, put it inside, like so, and then screw it down. And once you screw it down, you'll short the sense to the output to put in local sense. So let's take these out. So the part numbers for these parts are, for the green connector, 12 amp output connector plug, it's part number 1253-5826. And for the sense connector, it's the sense jumper, it's Agilent 8120-8821. So this is the next connector we're going to look at. This is for modules with 20 amp output current. So the four modules that use this connector are the N6731B, the N6741B, the N6754A, and the N6773A. So those four modules use this larger size connector. So this is a larger size connector here, so it's rated for 20 amps. And here's the larger size shorting bars. So this shorts the sense to the output. So the part numbers for these, so for the 20 amp connector plug right here, the part number is Agilent 1253-6211. And the part number for the sense jumper is Agilent 0360-2935. So if you need to order these parts, these are the numbers you would use. So this next one is the N6753A, and it's the 50 amp module. So this is the only module that uses this connector. You can see it's quite large to handle the 50 amperes. So this is the output connector. And this small one is the sense connector. So the jumper of the sense, you need to have this small one plugged into here. And the part numbers for these are, for the 50 amp output connector, the part number is Agilent 1253-7187. And for the smaller sense one, it's Agilent 1253-5830. So you would use those part numbers if you want to get spares or replacements or anything like that. So the last set of connectors we're going to look at are for the new Agilent N6780 series of SMU modules. So you can see that there's three different connectors here. Well, two connectors and an adapter. So the first one we're going to talk about is this one right here. And this is the main output connector for the N6781A, N6782A, and N6784A. The smaller connector, the 2-pin one, is for the auxiliary DVM input on the N6781A only, which we have right here. So that's an N6781A. So this connector goes into this port here for auxiliary DVM measurements. And the final thing we have is an adapter for putting a new Agilent N6780 SMU module into an Agilent N6705A DC power analyzer. So if you want to use an N6705A,
with one of the new SMU modules, you'll need to use this assembly. And there's a separate video that shows you how to install one of these modules into a N6705A mainframe. So let's quickly go through the part numbers for these. So for the main applet connector, this one right here, the part number is 1253-6408. For the 2-pin connector, the part number is 1253-8485. And for the adapter, the part number is 5188-8413. And these part numbers that we've mentioned for all these connectors are available through Agilent. So you can go to our website and you can order these parts.
So those are the various connectors that we use with the N6700 family of modular power supplies. If you have any questions or comments about this video, or any questions at all about our products, please feel free to contact us at the forum link included in the title card. Thank you. This has been Matt. Take care.